Thank you for attending RSI webinar today. My name is Rafał Gawenda and I will be running today's presentations together with my colleague Artur Kosakowski. The topic of this webinar is tips and tricks in robot. You can find information about our new series of robot webinars under these links. Let me remind you about the concept of RSI webinars. We will focus on one of several topics in order to discuss issues frequently submitted to the support team. We will begin with the general introduction of selected features of the program and develop these subjects further based on the feedback we will receive from you after each of the presentations. Please mind that these webinars are not supposed to be training sessions. The topic of today's webinars is tips and tricks in robot. We will show you options which can help you to create and design your structure easier and faster. The topic of next webinar is introduction to seismic and spectral analysis in robot. Let's begin from restoring robot defaults. Restoring default means that robot will start with the same settings as used during first start after installation. In case of unexpected behavior or noticing settings which are not possible to be easily changed, we recommend to restore default settings by clearing or deleting all the files inside CFG USR folder or renaming this folder. Default path is displayed on this slide. In case of having robot in a different version, the number 2016 should be changed onto 2015 or 2014. According to version you have used installed on your machine. Some comments about RTD file size. The file size by default are saved by default together with the model. So the file size of RTD is growing together with the results. Also, RC design components, still connections, produce some amount of data which is stored together with the data file. Typical way of reducing the size of the file is using save as command with the new name, specifying new name and selecting RTD file type without results. In case of many modifications and delete commands made in the model, they may also result in extending the file size of RTD. In such case, filing can be compacted by opening in repair mode when repair mode is active and open window. How to open file in repair mode? Repair mode is should be used in case of damaged RTD of its size of abnormally big because of many edit and delete operations. Of course, opening in repair mode removes from model its job's preferences and its properties and some other data not important from compound file point of view, so such as still connections, screen captures. That's why after opening file in repair mode, the default job preferences will be loaded together with the file opened in repair mode. How to properly open file in repair mode? We recommend to open file in this way. First of all, we should open file with correct settings of job preferences and then save these settings as a current parameters as default. Then restart or start new structure type and load the original model we want to open with repair mode in repair mode, and after opening we should save it or save us, use save us command to store every changes made during this operation. So the file will be loaded with the default job preferences. There is no import functionality in robot, but there are several interfaces to import models saved in different formats than RTD to robot. Selection of them should be done in open dialog window in file of type list. So all possible file types are listed on a screenshot on this slide. As concern robots export functionality, also there is no dedicated export feature in program. But to export model, one can use Save As option and select required format as Save As type list. Some remarks about DWG model import. After selecting DXF or DWG format in open window, we can adjust some import settings as shown on these slides. See the settings marked in red on slides. They are related to meshing and existence of AutoCAD and robot together on the same computer. So when the checkbox marked on this screenshot is not marked, means AutoCAD will use AutoCAD, which is installed on the same computer, will be used to mesh objects as surfaces or solids. When it is off, AutoCAD will not be used. Some settings related to importing of arcs and circles. But we recommend to fully control data and recommend to use constant number of divisions, fixed number of divisions to get desired effect. On the top part of this window, we can specify how the objects, AutoCAD objects, can be imported into robots. So if the both checkboxes are marked, selected, AutoCAD objects are converted into separate bars, surfaces, or solid elements. If both of them are switched off, AutoCAD objects are imported as lines, polylines, and contours. If top is off and bottom on, lines and polylines are converted into bars. Now some hints about modeling. If the snapping is set to nodes, the mouse cursor should precisely snap to nodes, and additionally, in such fields as marked in red on bars window, it is possible to type bars number, node numbers, to obtain precise and desired effect. It is possible to rotate sections bars with respect to local z-axis of already existing bar. As you can see on the screenshot, these three bars marked in red are rotated to orient their local z-axis in the same direction as local z of long bar number 2. To do so, position option is selected on gamma angle window, and as a reference, bar 2 is selected. Another option is a gamma angle window. On a gamma angle window is node option. Using it, one can easily set local z-axis direction to given point. Given point means node number. This option works only considering node number as a reference, so in case of need to set as a reference any 3D location, one should create a node in such location first. To lengthen bars, one should use scale option. So let's look at this example. After starting the scale option, we should select the center point of scaling, scaling ratio, and edit mode. So first of all, I will select bar number 2, specify ratio, and see the effect. Because I used edit mode copy, so the copy, the new bar member is created as a copy of bar number 2. Now we can switch to different mode, set the same center of scaling, and then use move option, so we can easily extend this way the node or the structure by moving the node. Selecting the copy command, we can duplicate bar number 2 in the direction of the local x-axis of bar number 2. How to merge bars? There is no such options in robot, but there is a robot add-in of this functionality already available on robot forum under the link listed on this slide. Add-in can be run directly from the hard disk, and or it can be added to menu item, as a menu item to add-ins menu, but add-ins manager. So I will start it from the menu, like make a selection, and then press merge. As all limitation of usage, or it's better to say the explanation why bars might not have been merged, are displayed on a warning window displayed after the process of merging. The fastest method to modify location of nodes, bars, panels, characteristic points, or panel edges is drag and drop functionality. So to activate drag and drop option, we should click twice in the same location, twice on the node, twice on a panel characteristic point, or twice in the middle of the bar or in the middle of the panel edge. Then cursor, mouse cursor switches to drag mode, and we can easily drag objects in the desired position. Keep in mind that it is not possible to set precise by values dragging vector. Mouse works only on snap points. If the bar is vertical member or a column, dragging of the top node moves the whole bar. How to adjust panels or contours? We can do it by dividing the panel edges. To do so, we need to use division, the same division option which can be used for bars. Then after selecting the edge can be divided by the option. And newly created points can be easily used later on in using drag and drop to correctly define geometry of such panel. There is a macro in Excel using robot API to merge panel edges. Merge, it means remove characteristic points on edges, on straight edges. It is available on the robot forum under the link listed on this site. How it works? We can just select the panel, start macro, short lock is displayed on the right-hand side column, and then after refreshing the screen, we can see that all characteristic points, all division points from the straight edges were automatically removed by this macro. Some hints about converting panels onto claddings and claddings onto panels. To change cladding onto panel, one should apply panel thickness to it. If panel should be changed onto cladding, it is required to apply curtain wall calculation model to such panel. How the selection works in robot? How powerful is the dialog window for the selection? Let's look at the example. So the selection dialog box, selection combo boxes are this listed on the top of the screen of robot. So predefined selection or some groups, already existing group of selection are listed in these combo boxes, so they can be easily selected by mouse. To make more advanced selection, we should open selection dialog window, and depending on the range of selection, I mean node, panel, bar, and by the attributes we can create different selections. So on this example, now we are selecting bars by nodes, and for now I'm selecting bars which are connected to the nodes using the selection dialog window. So depending on our need, we can use different attributes and different to create different selections. So it's fully interactive, so every selection can be adjusted to our needs using for example these buttons. The right hand side button is the common part button. Arrow with minus means subtraction from this already existing selection, plus button add to the selection some property, and two arrow button replaces already existing selection by the new one. Of course, using this selection dialog window, we can switch between bar selection or object selection online. It's also possible to create selection or modify selection by text syntax. So, for example, I have selected bars 1 to 5, and then after typing E like exclude, I excluded bar number 4 from the selection. There is a small hint how to select superbar, steel or team member superbars for the design, because they are not easily, they cannot be easily selected by any means. So there is a trick how to use bars table to select superbars. So on the structure, when we zoom a little, you can see it contains some superbars for steel design. So how to easily select them? First of all, we have to open bars table. On values tab. So then automatic selection is made, and then we will store it as a group. So I will call it a VT like value tab. Then after switching to edit tab, we have to press Ctrl A on keyboard and then copy this selection from this field to the clipboard. After closing window, closing tab, we have to paste all selection to the selection field and then create nodal group, bars group. So I will call it ET like edit tab. And then I will subtract ET's group from VT, and now you can see all super bars are selected. There is an also option which allows to select bars, select objects, nodes by structural axis. So this is the easiest way. We can just only need to click on the structural axis bubbles to activate selections. Structural axis can be also used to modify structure. So in this case, we have to click right hand mouse button on the bubble and select object properties. Now we can see we are in structural axis modification window, and we can play with different distances because of the checkbox which is called structure modification, which is on. Program automatically modifies the structure according to the settings of structural axis. There is a new selection feature implemented in Robot 2016. Similarly to Revit, it's possible to toggle objects for the selection pressing tab key. So for example, on this model, I want to select some elements pointing onto edge. So program will automatically highlight the current object which can be selected after pressing tab. So each pressing of the tab key highlights different object which is located or crossing the mouse cursor position. One more hint about the selection. Previous selection is available, so if we lose our selection or we make it empty, we can restore or use previous selection, and the option to activate is located on the right hand mouse click menu and then selecting previous selection item on the context menu. This is one of the most powerful features in a robot. You can automatically filter table which can be opened according to the selection made on the graphic screen. So this option is available on the right hand mouse button and selecting tables, and then we have to activate table filter to current selection on the or from the view menu view tables and then selecting the same item on the list. Using the tables, we are also allowed to change data in some separate cells. We call this selection or cross selection on tables. It works only on data tables. So first of all, we need to make any selection we want in any data table on edit tab. So selections means selecting the rows. Then left hand mouse click on the section or header of the table, and then for example we can select fill special and then change the property. And as you may see on the crossing cells of these selections, the property were changed. As a default, program represents results in bar forces table in two points, beginning and end node. To get results in different points, especially for diagrams characteristic points, it's required to click right hand mouse button on table and then select table columns, then points. So once we are on division points tab, we have to activate characteristic points radio button, then press refresh button, and after pressing OK, the data will be automatically transferred to, for example, forces table. How to interact with Excel? We can easily retrieve the data and the results from any table in robot by ordinary copying by keyboard. Control C, Control V command can be used, so every table can be copied this way. Also, it's possible to store every table in CSV format, which the option is available on the right hand mouse click menu. It's also possible to do the same exchange or similar exchange with the data on edit tabs data of data tables. So first I will copy all nodes of the structure, then all bars. The important remark: to exchange the data from Excel to robot by copying by clipboard of the tables, it's required to use correct cell types in Excel. So for example, value cell in robot should be number type of the cell, should have number type of the cells in Excel. So now I'm copying notes from Excel to nodes table in robot. The same with bars. In case of copying, like shown on now, the user cannot control numbering, so nodes and bars should be created in the continuous order. there is inline, or what is better to say, infield calculator in many fields in dialog windows of robot. This inline calculator is not implemented in table cells. How to activate it? Just type the formula inside the cell and then press equal sign on the keyboard to see the result. Available functions and syntax on the slide. It is possible to modify loads graphically. So when the loads are displayed, load symbols are displayed, we can click right-hand mouse button on such symbol and then select object properties. And either we can modify it one by one or one particular load, or we can work on selection. So now I will select all loads with the same load and modify all of these loads in one run. So to do so, we need to activate for the selected objects. Using the same option, we can, let's say, copy or duplicate the load. So I will add to the selection some more loads and activate the same option from the right-hand mouse click menu, load properties. I will not change anything, but just only add the load for the selection. As you may see, some loads are copied to different locations. On the right-hand mouse click, there is also delete option. So you can easily delete graphically the loads. Diagram labels, object names, text symbols can be modified and moved by user on graphic screen by mouse. So to activate this, we should click somewhere in the middle of the text and then just drag the mouse. On the right-hand click menu, we can see additional options available for such elements like delete, delete added text, and text sort properties. So for such items, we can add such some descriptions if we want, and then place correctly it on our view. So we can delete some items from the display, delete added text, to restore default settings or default description, we should go to View menu and then Descriptions submenu. So here we can find all other possible functionalities to restore previous display of labels and texts. How to obtain exact mesh as created in AutoCAD. To do so, we need to import the .exe file or the .dwg file, and then we need to create the mesh in a special way. So first of all, we need to create the panels which should be defined in the way to cover automatically all regions. To do so, we have to specify syntax all in the object list field. And now, as you can see, program automatically detected all closed contours and created inside them panels. Now we need to adjust meshing parameters. So we will force program to mesh these panels with one finite element only. So we need to deactivate characteristic points and emitters and set user defined divisions one by one. And after meshing, program will create one element each field. Now we can easily delete all remaining bars which were important as a temporary bars, and now to avoid high number of panels inside the model, we can reduce them by creating one outer panel from the selection. So we need to create the new panel from the selection of finite elements. To do so, I will make selection of finite elements by polygon. And now, as you can see, as a final result, we have just only one panel with fixed mesh. Small recap from the first and second webinar about the recommended meshing options. So on the left part, correct settings in job preferences. So we should use iterative adjustment of finite elements without kinematic constraints. And the recommended meshing options listed on the right-hand side. Screenshot, so most important information is that some grayed out fields should be also deactivated. To do so, we need to activate the delaney method, uncheck them, and then switch back to Kunz method. Many know how to create extruded or revolved objects, but how to modify created objects? So on this example, I have the cylinder. Cylinder was created by the extrusion of the circle. So to on the right-hand mouse click menu, we can select object properties and change edges discretization of edges. It will change discretization of our base and top decks of our cylinder. So this option will not make any influence on the extrusions parameter. So this option only changes parameters for the base and top circles. To modify extrusion parameter, we should use the option shown before. And now we can adjust either division number, so number of divisions along the length of the cylinder, and it's also possible to change or modify the vector of the extrusion. So I can easily change here the size, the length, the height of the object. So now meshed model. How to set auxiliary property for the cases which have no such options in parameters? There are several types of load cases which have no such parameter listed. So to do so, we have to create or make selection, case selection, and then press change analysis type button and set, for example, auxiliary property, and it will be, after pressing OK, it will be shown on the analysis types window that is properly set. In the same way, we can easily play with selection of cases. We can delete them, change the analysis type. So we need once again to create case list selection and the use buttons marked in red on this window. How to create user automatic load combinations? It's possible to do in robot to create automatic code combination, but we recommend to start creating such code combinations by modifying already existing shipped with robot regulation file by adding subnatures, adjusting factors, selecting setting formulas. All regulation files have the extensions RGL, and there are text files so that it can be easily changed or seen by any text editor. The default location of these files is in all users folder, and at the end, as you can see on the slide, is RGL folder. So all regulation file or code combinations file which are shipped together with robot are located there. If one will create your own regulation file, such file should be saved, stored in robot's CFG USR folder. How to create code combinations, how to deal with them. On these examples, you can see how to create such code combination regulation file using internal editor. So the internal editor is located in job preferences. We can start with the existing code combination file, change code name, and it's recommended also to change file name. The file will be saved in CFG USR folder. Yes, and now we can adjust the regulations according to our needs. On the top part, we can create as natures, subnatures, and some factors. On the bottom part, for different type of combinations, we have to select different formulas. And after storing, we can load it in job preferences to our model. So to see it works, I will open code combinations dialog window, and the active code combination file is listed on the top, and also after pressing generate, we can see it on the next window. It is possible to generate nice 3D stress map on bar elements in stress analysis structure module. But as a default program resizes the sections to make better display of such maps. To restore original correct scale of the sections, we have to press home button on the keyboard. How to create or how to obtain such map? When we are in stress analysis structure, we have to click on the right-hand side top button and then wait a little to activate to generate such map. Then I will rescale a little, and then after pressing home, model returns to the original state. Few hints about printouts, how to make printouts, how to deal with the printout and screen captures. To prepare our report, we can make the screenshots if screen captures. If you want to modify them later on, we recommend to use screen captures updatable upon printing. Screen captures can be made from any graphical view, from any table, from any calculation node, either from the right-hand mouse click menu or from top button with the camera icon or from file menu. So I will create some screen captures with data, with results, results diagram, and then from the forces table. So once done, we can see them on screen capture tabs in the printout composition wizard, so we can easily move them to our report. And while in preview, we can adjust the report to our needs. On the top, there are located some buttons we can use to adjust the reports. Every screen capture can be edited. So I am editing now the first screen capture. And now by resizing the window, I will try to fit the screen capture window, the structure view, onto the page view. Of course, in the edition, we can easily add any attribute to be displayed later on. So for example, I will now add sections symbols. On the preview, we can also have two additional items, such as rotate screen capture, set scale. So on the preview, we can adjust this. Now I am editing table, so in table we can resize any column, any row. We can make any filtering either from the top dialog combo box or from the filter menu. The same, we can adjust any screen capture with the results according to our needs. So I will add some labels. And once again, editing results, screen capture results table. So I will adjust it by removing some columns. Okay, let's select this. Of course, filtering can be done either by filters or from the top menu. We can add some columns if we want. And after returning to preview, we can see how it is adjusted. Hints from the previous webinars for steel design, how to create groups for a single member. So on a groups tab, we have to type this syntax to create automatically groups containing one member each. For the steel design, we need sometimes to print this small table. So the screen capture of this table screen capture options for this table is not available. So under calculation node button, we can select save table option, then label the screen capture, and then the screen capture of this table will be added to our screen captures in printout composition wizard. Let me remind you what was already said for the design of RC beams and columns, but what applies to slabs and walls also. In case you need to add new diameter of reinforcement bars or new steel grade, you should edit the reinforcement bars database. To do so, go to Job Preferences, select database you want to edit, and open it with the indicated button. The same applies to wire fabrics. Some useful add-ins developed by us and some end users, robot forum users, can be found on this link. Sizing the opportunity, I would like to introduce to you Autodesk Knowledge Network site, where you can find useful articles on the topics covered during this webinar, as well as on many others. Thank you for attending our webinar, and now we can open question and answer part of our session. Feel free to ask questions in the question panel on GoTo webinar window.
Okay, thank you, Rafał, for this interesting presentation. It was surprising for me that I managed to learn a couple new tricks that I was not aware of. So as Rafał mentioned, please, if you want to ask some questions, this is the right moment for doing so. We'll try to answer them online. And if not possible, we'll post the answer on the forum later on. So I suggest to use the forum for asking questions too.
So the first question was, how do you insert an active robot window into PowerPoint? It's not any trick, it's just a recorded movie inside the PowerPoint presentation. So the next question is, I have edited the load table, table and edition tab, and the gray first column has disappeared. How can I get it back? So as far as I understood, you don't have this first column grayed out with, let's say, nothing displayed. There is, for any table, there is a, when the table is active, you can go to the format and try to see what happens here and try to restore defaults. But I would personally start from the tools menu, customize, and open layers from template. I hope it should automatically restore default. If not, you can try to restore robot default by clearing robot CFG USR folder. So this was presented on my first slide. As previously, this webinar is recorded and will be published in a few days on our YouTube channel, and you should see it on our playlist of robot webinars. There are some questions not especially related to our topic of today's webinar, so I kindly advise you to post them on our forum so we can handle them there. This is not another good question. How to restore sorting order in loads table or in any load? So if we have load table and we filter it or sort it, let's say by list field or by data field, so automatically the sorting order of the case is changed. To restore default sorting, make double click on this cell. Will return to the original state of the table.
There is one question about showing one more time where you can edit loads combination.
Edit loads, I mean, I guess, how to create code combination regularly. Code combination file, code combination regulations, and then use three dots button to run our internal editor. The recommended way is to change the code name, let's say webinar, and I recommend also to use the same name for the file. So I will save it as a webinar file. Okay, then we need to adjust just nature, subnature, all factors, then formulas for different type of combinations which can be generated. Then after creating, we can use more button and then find it on our list somewhere. Okay. Unfortunately, I don't see it on the list because I saved it in 2015 folder. Okay, let's do it once again. So once again, webinar 2016. File save as. So instead of 2015 CFG USR folder, I should select 2016 CFG USR webinar 2016. Okay. So once again, after closing, using more, it should be listed. Okay, here. So now we need to move it to our current project. Set as a default, close project preferences, and then we can see it in automatic code combinations window. The question about copying and pasting loads table. Of course it is possible, so let's try load table. But as I mentioned, it's required to have the same cell types or similar cell types in Excel to be copied back. So maybe from the first run will not work. And let's do it this way. I will delete whole table and then select everything once again in Excel, Control C to copy to clipboard, and then paste. Yeah, so as you may see, many of the items is copied, but as I told you, the correct cell types should be set in Excel to properly copy cells between these two programs. But it should be possible.
I think that what you have to do is when you look at the load table, there are numbers, and then there is a separate column for load case name. So you make sure that in Excel, you actually, the first column is like, yeah, so two columns. So, but it is possible. Of course, the number of load cases should be created prior to copying from the Excel.
Exactly. If there are no more questions, I want to really thank you for attending today's webinar. And I would like to invite you for the next webinar, which will be presented on the 16th of September due to the summer break, vacation break. And the topic of the next presentation will be Introduction to Seismic and Spectral Analysis in Robot. Once again, thank you for attending this webinar. Goodbye.
Thank you, Rafael.